An easy way to add a circular hole is by beveling a vertex. You can do this by selecting a vertex and pressing Shift-Ctrl-B. Then scroll the mouse wheel up to add more segments. You can also increase or decrease the segments with the plus and minus keys on the numpad. Or, after left-clicking to confirm, increase the segments in the operator panel. To make it round, adjust the profile shape to 0.0865. Or, even easier, right-click and use Loop Tools Circle for a perfect circle. Loop Tools is an extension that you need to enable in Preferences. Then you can extrude these faces inwards. You can even do this with several vertices at once. And then press Alt-E and choose Extrude Faces along Normals. This works fine in a quick Boolean workflow, but it creates n-gons, faces with more than four edges. Although in some cases n-gons are fine even in a subdiff workflow, if you're going for an all-quads workflow, for sculpting for example, you'll want to avoid n-gons. In that case, you'll need at least three intersecting edge loops. In Edge Selection mode, select two intersecting edges and press Ctrl-B to bevel them. Here too, you can increase segments with the middle mouse button or by pressing the plus key on the numpad, or after left-clicking to confirm by adjusting the segments in the operator panel. You need two segments to get three intersecting edges like this. Switch back to Vertex Selection mode and bevel the vertex in the center as before with Shift-Ctrl-B. You can also do this by going to Vertex Bevel Vertices and move the mouse until you see it change. Adjust the profile in the operator panel or use Loop Tools Circle. Now to get all quad topology, select two vertices at a time while holding Shift and then press J to connect them. Switch to Face Selection mode and select the faces. Press E to extrude them to create a hole. If you don't want to keep those extruded faces, press Delete or X and choose Faces. Now, when you add a subdiff modifier, it will become more round, but also smooth. To keep the corners sharp, you can do a couple of things. You can select the corner edges and increase them by pressing Shift-E and 1 on the numpad, or slide the mean crease value to the right in the option panel with those edges selected. Now, despite the subdiff modifier, the corner remains sharp. Alternatively, we can do some more beveling. With those edges selected, press Ctrl-B and then move the mouse. You'll want a profile shape of 1 for this, and 2 segments is enough to keep the corners sharp. The closer together those edge loops are, the sharper the corner will be. When exporting a mesh to other software, you want to add geometry like this to keep corners sharp, because creasing only works inside of Blender. Right-click and choose Shade Auto Smooth to make it look even smoother. Blender 5 has really nice matcaps that you can use to make your models more visually appealing in the viewport. Learning how to make holes, either with Booleans or with subdivision-ready topology, is one of the key skills that you need to have as a 3D artist. I've learned this the hard way, but I've struggled so you don't have to. I've collected all my knowledge about hole modeling in a new PDF, The Big Book of Holes. You can get this now on my website or on YouTube. If you already have my Big Blender Secrets book, you don't need this PDF as you already have all these topics in that book. So if you want to learn all there is about holes in 3D modeling, go and get that PDF.